Find the pressure of water and what phase it is in, if it has a specific volume of 0.9 cubic meters per kilogram, and a temperature of 180 degrees Celsius. Remember to try solving this problem yourself before watching the solution. This is the third example for the interpolation and mixture quality 9-minute lecture video. The links to the other examples on this topic and the other lectures of the thermodynamics course are found in the description below. This problem is very similar to the previous one, except we'll have to double interpolate for both the pressure and the temperature. We start by going to the saturated mixture tables to determine the phase of our substance. In this case, the saturated mixture table by temperature. We find here that for a temperature of 180 degrees Celsius, Vg is 0.19, which means that our water, which has a higher specific volume, is in a superheated phase. With this information, we go to our superheated tables and look for a temperature of 180 degrees Celsius. Since in this table we don't have rows for a temperature of 180, we need to kinda create it. How do we do that? Well, even though you already know that linear interpolation is not very precise, we'll interpolate the specific volume values for temperatures between 150 and 200 degrees Celsius. We are still looking for a specific volume equal to 0.9 and for a temperature value that is between 150 and 200. If you pay close attention, for a pressure of 200 kilopascals and a temperature of 180, meaning somewhere between 150 and 200, we'd have a specific volume just above 1 cubic meter per kilogram, or at least between 0.96 and 1.08. This is close to what we're looking for, but still higher than the 0.9 we have. We know that a higher pressure will condense our gas, meaning a lower specific volume, which is what we want to find. So we move to the next subtable, the table for 300 kilopascals, and see that for a temperature of 180, or somewhere between 150 and 200, the specific volume would be between 0.63 and 0.72. With all of this information, we know that the pressure must be between 200 and 300 kilopascals. The first interpolation we do here is to find the specific volume of a temperature of 180 degrees for each of the two pressure values. We've done this interpolation in previous examples, so I won't go into detail here. You can watch the previous examples in the main lecture video linked below if you haven't already. This process would yield a specific volume of 1.03 cubic meters per kilogram. We perform the same calculations using the values for the 300 kilopascal pressure, and we find that for a temperature of 180, the specific volume is 0.68. With this, we've basically created the row for 180 degrees Celsius, at least for the specific volume information we need. And this confirms our specific volume is between 200 and 300 kilopascals. And now we use this information just like we did for our previous example. We have 0.68 for 300 kilopascals, 1.03 for 200 kilopascals, and we interpolate linearly to find the pressure for our given specific volume of 0.9. This process yields 238 kilopascals. Done! If you want to check out the other examples for this same topic, the main lecture video, or other lectures of the thermo course and other engineering courses, make sure to check out the links in the description below. Thanks for watching!